colleagues, it's Thusana and PMC, but I'm just going to do a quick video about one stock which is potentially a shorting case. But yeah, the main reason is not about which stock it is. What I'm putting across is the methodology. If you can pick the methodology, then you might have gained something in your investment arsenal. So here I go. What I did is I ran a scan on Finviz. Basically, on the scan, what I was scanning for was a market cap larger than 10 billion. It's just my philosophy, my style of trading. I want to trade the big stocks, more so because I use options also, and those options are a little bit more liquid, and I'm a small fish in that space. I can easily get in and get out, even with my option structuring. So yes, I want the large cap over 10 billion, and the higher it is, the better for me. That's just like my cutoff. Then also, I want it to be optionable because I use option structures for trading. I don't just buy normal stocks. So that's the basic two items which I put on my scan first and upfront. Then on this particular scan, I went to look for stocks making new highs because I want to short the market. I'm of the opinion that currently the market is at a high, and I'm looking for sectors where the market is overbought and I can have a better option of shorting. I'm not just looking at one stock, but I'm looking at a sector with the stocks making new highs. Then I can zero in on that sector and find a stock which I can short. So once I ran this scan, I got lots of stocks, up to 4 pages of this. So it's 4 times 20 is about 80. Yesterday I made a video on Thomson Reuters. It's on the service sector, that one. I'm just scrolling quickly for you to see all these stocks are making new highs. We have 72 of them making new highs. If you just zero in and highlight the ticker symbol there, you'll see that there's the graph making new highs. There's the graph making new highs. There it is. So all of these are making new highs. So what I did is, as I'm of the opinion that I want to find a sector, I looked at this. I could see consumer goods appearing several times there. I've also filtered according to market cap. So the highest market cap is coming at the top. So consumer goods is popping up a lot. On the second page, we still have consumer goods appearing there, but you can see also utilities. So what I do once I get this scenario is I go and filter the sectors which I'm seeing appearing several times. Like in this case, consumer goods, services, utilities. So what I'll do is I'll go and filter now by sector. Filtered by utilities, you get utilities, technology, services, industrial, financial, you can see them keep popping up there, those sectors. Financials is well pronounced, there are lots of them. And consumer goods is big also there. But what I went with was I zeroed in on utilities. Then when I zeroed in on utilities, I went and picked the top stock there with the highest market cap, which is NEE. The ticker symbol is NEE, NextEra Energy, electrical utilities. There it is. On Friday, it made a new high. Then I looked at this. I did not go into the technicals, into the fundamentals that much. I just went and zeroed in on technicals because that's my core focus for this video. On the technicals, I went and used my normal standard template, pulled the monthly chart, I just pull it at 20 to get more. The monthly chart, there we go. It's been grouping, and it's grouped again. So this is at the top, and if you run RSI, it's back to the highs which it last made there. So RSI is giving us a flat scenario, and price has zoomed all the way up there to new highs. So this is divergence of some sort, and giving me a sell signal for the monthly chart. If I go to the weeklies, to the weekly chart, using a 5 year feed of information, I also get a grouping again. So now the monthly chart is saying this is a top because of the grouping. The weekly chart is giving me a top also because of the grouping. What is RSI doing? It's flat. It has hit the same height for the third time now, when the price has been making new highs. Clear sell divergence on the weekly and the monthly. Then lastly, on the daily, what am I seeing? On the daily, we have the same scenario also. Grouping at the top there and making a new high, and RSI, it's a little bit tricky here because it's not showing me any reverse divergence at all. But with those two, the weekly and the monthly, showing me clear reverse divergence, the daily making new highs, I expect this stock to tank. And this is a situation where I would definitely call this a top. These are some of the scenarios which last year I was very confident of saying this type of stock is topping, and it's a topping zone, and I'm prepared to short it using options. Even if it goes against me for a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, but eventually after say 3 months, I would have killed it because definitely it would have dropped. And yeah, that was just what I wanted to show you, multiple time frame analysis of new highs. If the highs are there on weekly, daily, and monthly, and the technical analysis, whatever template you use for assessing your stocks, is telling you that this is a sell zone, that's what I got. For me, I want to see the grouping. I want to see divergence. If I see groupings at the top and divergence being replicated in the weekly and the monthly chart, I know I'm up to something, and that's why I'll call this one a shorting zone. At this level here, I'm looking at taking some shots. And yeah, that's me. That's a short one. Just wanted to call multiple time frame analysis and how I get to screen these stocks, how I get this fit for my stocks to screen. Yeah, I just gave an example looking at utilities. From this scan, you can see that utilities, there's 13 utility stocks making new highs on the same day. And when you go into the depth, I just picked the top one. There might be several ones also making multiple time frame tops. So when you do your multiple time frame analysis and you find a stock matching all three, you now decide which ones. But if there was time, I would go into relative strength analysis, comparative relative strength analysis, to pick one of those stocks in a sector. In this case, I picked the top one. It's not just the best idea to do. Rather compare them, find maybe three or four confirming to the multiple time frame analysis and shorting zones. Then you compare those three, which one is the best one for shorting using comparative relative strength. But it's not just utilities. You could have focused on technology and found which one matched your scenario. Technology, another sector which is predominant, you can see it's coming several times there, it's services. Healthcare and financials, diversified ICE. I'm very interested in ICE. I'll have a look at it some other time. Financials keep popping up there. Yeah, and consumer goods. But my interest is in the one which I did yesterday. It should be under services. Yeah, Thomson and Reuters. There we are. I looked at this one in a video yesterday. But yeah, that is that. I'll leave it at that, guys. My tech, I run the scan. You just go back there. I run the scans. Scan is based on basically three conditions. A market cap larger than 10 billion. It needs to have options and option shortable. After that, I just look at stocks which are making new highs for the past 20 days. Then I group them according to sectors. Then in those sectors, I pick one which is conforming to the multiple time frame analysis. That's it. I thank you, colleagues. Tusana and PM Sebata. I'm out.